Hello, this is Clay from thejapanshop.com. Reading is one of the best ways to learn vocabulary, improve your understanding of Japanese sentence structure, and understanding grammar. But it can be a challenge, especially for beginners. Today in this video, I will show you how to quickly look up words using a browser plugin, a free browser plugin called Yomichan. With this plugin, you can quickly look up words, find example sentences, and look up the pitch accent. Again, it's completely free. Now, reading native level Japanese is something you should do every day. However, without some help, it may be more frustrating than productive for beginners. And by the way, if you are a beginner or upper beginner, I do recommend our digital bundles. Every sentence is broken down, every word defined, and grammar is explained. And of course, your support is greatly appreciated. But if you are an upper beginner or intermediate or above, you need to be reading native level Japanese, and it's never been easier. And with Yomichan, it is easy to read a novel in your browser or read the latest news article. Simply go to the Yomichan website, and I'll leave a link below in the description, and you can read all about what it does. It even has on-demand audio playback for most words. You can see the kanji stroke diagrams for clicking on the characters. For installation, you have two choices, Google Chrome and Firefox. Now, I'm actually using the Brave browser, which is something I totally recommend, especially if you're privacy-focused. But Brave browser works with Chrome. It's based on the Chrome architecture, so click on that if you're using Brave. Once you do that, you install it, and then you come back to this web page to download the dictionaries. If you're a beginner, I recommend just getting the English-Japanese dictionary here, unless your native language is not English, and then the pitch accent dictionary at the bottom here. I recommend starting with those two, because as you add more to these, it fills up all of the options, and it can be kind of a mess to parse through and try to figure out what is the best translation for what. If you're an intermediate level, go ahead, have fun, download everything, because it's the more information is better, and you know what to look for. I assume you have it installed, and let's give it a try. Now, if you're a beginner, I recommend starting with NHK's News Web Easy page. Again, we'll leave the link in the description below. It has recent Japanese news articles, but in simpler Japanese, and all of the kanji have furigana over them, so you can read them even if your kanji ability isn't that great. I'm just going to pick one of them. This one looks kind of cute. Cheetah no akachan. So there's a baby cheetah in Wakayama-ken. Now, this easy web obviously already has furigana, so you can get the reading without having to use Yomichan, but let's say you just don't know what Wakayama-ken is. If you mouse over it and hold down the shift key, it gives you the definition, which of course is Wakayama Prefecture. So what I do is I often just kind of start reading an article, and if there's a word I don't know at all, of course I look it up. If there's a word that I kind of know, but I don't know maybe the pitch accent, then you can come down here, and this shows the pitch accent. So this is a Heiban word, umareru. Instead of umareru, it's umareru. You can get the correct pronunciation here, or I should say the standard Japanese pronunciation. Depending on what you have installed, the more you have installed, the more information it'll give you. But again, I think if you're a beginner, just stick with the main dictionary and the pitch accent dictionary, and then you will get all this information here. Now, let's say also you want to study, say, what does this kanji actually mean? You can click on the kanji, and you can see the stroke order and meanings, readings, which, of course, this is one of them that has just a ton of readings. Oh, my goodness. I knew this would be a lot, but that's insane. Anyway. It tells you the JLPT level, and I don't know if that's N5 or if it's the old 4 level, but because I would assume that would be on the easiest test, N5 level. Anyway, and the grade level would be the Japanese elementary school grade level. First graders learn it. Stroke count and frequency, I guess that's tied to newspaper, how often it shows in newspaper, maybe in novels as well. So it's a very, very common word, kanji, of course. And you can look it up depending on what kanji textbook you're looking at, it gives you all that information. And all this information is absolutely free. That's just amazing. And another good thing about the Easy Web, it also has a recording where you can listen to them. You can turn off the furigana and turn it on. It's very, very good for beginners. And of course, it works with any website. So yeah, I like to read a news article a day and just to try to learn new vocabulary and to see what's happening in the world, or in Japan, actually. I'm more interested in what's happening in Japan. So you can, you know, go on to an article in Taifu Juyongo. You can say, what is this? High wave. And you look and say, yeah, high waves, heavy seas. And it gives you the pronunciation, takanami. And so you can read through articles easily. Now, reading in itself, you will learn vocabulary words, you'll learn about pronunciation and so forth. But to help it stick, it's best to make it flashcards. And I use personally the Anki program, which is free, except for the iPhone. It costs a little bit of money for the iPhone, but it's, you know, I really only use it for the iPhone. I believe there's a way you can connect your Yomichan to go directly into Anki, but since I only use it on my iPhone, and I think it's important to actually physically type things in, it helps you, it's one more layer to help you remember the word. I tend to do that. So whenever I see a new word, I put it in my Anki, and then every day I review my Anki. If you were not familiar with Yomichan, I highly recommend installing it, stopping what you're doing right now, and install it. The links are in the description below. If you are familiar with Yomichan or some other, there are other browser extensions, I would love to hear your thoughts on it in the comments below. How do you use it to improve your Japanese vocabulary? So until next time, this has been Clay from thejapanshop.com. Bye.